Hi, and welcome. My name is Tammy Bednar. I'm a Senior Director of Product Management, and I focus on our Oracle Exadata Database Cloud services. Today, over the next few minutes, I'd like to talk to you about multi-cloud development using Microsoft Azure and the Oracle Database Cloud. So multi-cloud is the new normal. Maybe you've heard that, maybe you haven't. But let's take a look at the state of multi-cloud. Did you know that over 98% of customers' organizations are using or plan to use multiple clouds within the next 6 months? In fact, at Oracle Cloud World last year, in the audience, I asked the customers how many of you are using multiple clouds. And it surprised me to find out that the majority of users have 3 and 4 multi-clouds they're using to run their business. Now, why do you think that is? Well, first of all, data sovereignty and data locality, cost optimization, business agility and innovation, and mergers and acquisitions. But the number one challenge that many of our customers or what we hear is the interoperability between different cloud vendors for multi-cloud. But with OCI, multi-cloud is real and practical. You can use the best of breed services across multiple providers for the same workload. And security is always important. You don't want to have to choose a different security model between more than one different cloud provider. So unified security with federated identity and integrated logging. And performance and latency is very important between databases and applications. And so you want to make it look like it can be equivalent to that of a single cloud. And finally, logging and metrics can be unified with a third party or integrated into a single pane of glass with one cloud UI. So I'm really excited to talk to you about the Oracle-Microsoft partnership. This partnership is not new. In fact, we've been working together for over 5 years. It all started because of customers like you. You told us, hey, I use your applications, I use your databases, I know you have data centers all over the world that are very close together. How about if you get together and figure out a way to interconnect those different data centers so we can run our applications and database services? So our engineers got together from both teams and they came out with the OCI Azure Interconnect. The OCI Azure Interconnect is a networking solution that provides very slow latency between Oracle and Microsoft Azure data centers. In fact, the OCI Azure Interconnect is still used today by over 400 of our customers. So fast forward a few more years, and we introduced Oracle Database for Azure. Now, what that did is it took the interconnected regions using the OCI Azure Interconnect and automated the network connectivity. This gives you an opportunity to very quickly and efficiently use the Oracle Database for Azure solution, and it's very cost effective. Okay, so last year we talked about a new expanded partnership introducing Oracle Database at Azure. What does this provide? It actually delivers the Oracle Database services to be directly co-located into the Microsoft Azure regions. This is really exciting. So with the Oracle Database services co-located in the Azure regions, this gives you the opportunity to migrate, modernize, and innovate critical applications. You can take those enterprise applications that are running against the Oracle Database and the virtual machines where those applications are running and experience microseconds of latency between the resources. You can modernize and innovate your applications that maybe you're running on-premise, but really need to run in a cloud environment. You can modernize those with CI/CD processes and gradually implement microservices or build new modern applications with the latest development tools and use those with the Oracle databases running in Oracle Database at Azure. And finally, data and analytics. This is very popular with our customers today to be able to combine Azure analytic capabilities with the highest performing and most scalable Oracle database services. So let's take just a little deeper dive into this Oracle Database at Azure solution. So first of all, this solution is putting Oracle Database services with its infrastructure inside Microsoft Azure availability zones in regions where this is offered. Now, the Oracle Database service that is being offered is called Exadata Database Service on Dedicated Infrastructure. What that means is all the hardware that you provision is dedicated to you. And the infrastructure consists of Oracle database servers and storage servers. So essentially, this is an extension of the Oracle Cloud into Microsoft Azure. So the infrastructure is available in multiple zones in each region where the solution is offered. How does this benefit you overall? Well, first of all, this means that you're not limited to a single cloud to select the best of breed services and Oracle database services as well. Also, this is very cost effective and very easy solution to connect the Azure VNets to your Oracle database that are co-located in your Azure region. And finally, you're able to use the same native tools between Oracle and Azure to provision and manage the lifecycle of your Oracle databases. So, what tools can I use to develop an Oracle database in Azure environment? Let's take a look at a few of those automated or cloud automation tools. So, first one is the Azure UI. So, since the Exadata database service is co-located in the Azure regions, you can see with this screenshot that we're using the Microsoft Azure console to provision the Exadata infrastructure. So remember, the Exadata database service infrastructure consists of database servers and storage servers. So in step one of this provisioning, you specify what the shape is of the infrastructure with the resources that you want to use. How many database servers? How many storage servers, and how do you want to perform the maintenance on this infrastructure? Once you enter all those details, you say provision. The next step is to provision Exadata VM cluster. An Exadata database VM cluster sits on top of the infrastructure that you just provisioned. Now, the VM cluster is where you identify all the different resources that will be used for databases that will be created inside your VM cluster. So you will select or enter the information such as number of OCPUs, memory, and the amount of storage that you want to use for the databases that will be provisioned. Also, you can select the licensing type, whether it's bring your own license or license included. Once you select the VNet that will be used to connect to your Oracle database VM cluster, you press provision. Fantastic. Now we have the infrastructure, we have the VM cluster, we're ready to create our databases. There's a link inside the Azure console that says jump to OCI, and it will place you with the federated identity using EntID directly into the OCI console to create your Oracle database. You select create database and you enter the detailed information with a few steps to create your database. Maybe you need a unique database name, you can enter it here, your database version, and all the databases that are created through the UI utilize the CDB and PDB architecture. Once you've entered all the information along with the administrator credentials, you press create database. So that's all there is to creating a database using the UI. Okay, so maybe you're not a UI person and you rather use command line. Well, we have a tool for that called the command line interface. The OCI CLI extends the OCI console's functionality and enables data engineers and developers to automate tasks through scripting programmatically. So how do you use the OCI CLI with your Exadata database server that's in Azure? Go to our product documentation and install the OCI CLI on your preferred client. You can run it from a Linux operating system, Mac OS, and Windows. Now, if you're running this from OCI, you can provision the Oracle Linux Cloud developer image because it already has the CLI pre-installed. Or you can run it from the OCI or Azure Cloud Shell via the web browser-based terminal. With the OCI CLI, it supports all the lifecycle management of your Exadata database service as well as database. So let's take a look at how to use the OCI CLI with the Azure Cloud Shell. As you can see, we are already in the Microsoft Azure console, and I clicked on the Azure Cloud Shell button, and then I selected Bash. Now we've already installed the OCI CLI here. And here you can see a few examples of how to run the OCI CLI. You can use the OCI CLI for all your DB operations, such as managing your SSH keys, or you can change your licensing model. You can list and apply VM cluster updates and upgrades. You can scale your resources. And of course, all the lifecycle management tasks for your databases and database homes. So maybe you want to use a different tool like REST, for example. The OCI REST is used to provide programmatic access via HTTPS to the functions that interact with backend resources. You can provision and manage the database deployments for the Oracle Exadata database service by using these REST APIs. The REST API calls map to one of the following HTTP requests: get, post, put, and delete. You can access the Exadata database service using REST APIs using the REST endpoint URL that's associated with your service. You can find that URL in the documentation. Now, many of the REST API operations do require JSON in the request body, or it will return JSON in the response body. When you execute the REST API call, the HTTP response code indicates whether the request was successful or not. So here's an example of using the REST API with Postman. Here, we are updating the Exadata database VM cluster, and we're scaling up the number of OCPUs that we need to run our database workloads. As you can see, we are issuing a put command for the cloud VM cluster, and we specify the number of CPU counts that we want the VM cluster to execute on. As you can see, we ran the command from Postman, and now VM cluster has been updated with more OCPUs. So this is how you can scale up and scale down your VM cluster OCPUs. So recently, you can find our OCI database service API references in our documentation in the link on the left. Recently, Postman has also updated the service API collections within the tool itself. So it's going to make it much easier for you to create scripts to manage the lifecycle of your database and your VM clusters using REST APIs. Okay, finally, Terraform. So when I hear customers talk about Terraform, they're usually referring to infrastructure as a code model. Terraform allows you to duplicate or rebuild your existing infrastructure architecture in a new tenancy or region. It also allows you to detect state drift of your Terraform managed resources. So how do you use Terraform with your Exadata database service? Well, there is a Terraform provider, and you can find that in the documentation. You'll configure the Terraform provider information using all the tenancy details, such as OSID, user OSID, region, private and public key, and fingerprint of the key pair. You can describe the Exadata database service infrastructure into a Terraform configuration file. And when you want to run Terraform, you initialize it, you run it, and then you apply the configuration. So let's take a look at how we can run a Terraform script within Microsoft Azure console again using the Cloud Shell. Once again, you can see this example of how we're creating an OCI pluggable database. We've already created the scripts, and now we're just initializing it, we're planning it, and we're applying the Terraform script to create that PDB. And this is just an example of what the Terraform script can look like. And now we're off creating our new pluggable database. All right, now we've talked about all the different cloud automation tools that are available to you today to provision your Oracle databases. You can use the UI, you can use OCI CLI, you can use REST API, and you can use Terraform. So now you're ready to connect to your database. The tools that we have available here, for example, are Visual Studio Code, very popular today. And Visual Studio Code has Oracle Developer Tool extensions available for you to install. The links on the left point to the documentation on the Oracle Developer Tools for Visual Studio Code, and also the Oracle SQL Developer Extension for Visual Studio Code as well. So you can go to the database itself, and with OCI and within OCI, you'll be able to find the connect string information to enter it into Visual Studio Code to connect to your database. Another option that's been available for a very long time is SQL Developer. On the left-hand side, you will see a couple of URLs to the documentation and where you can download SQL Developer into your platform. Again, using the connect string information from the OCI console, you fill out the information to connect to your database. Okay, so over the last few minutes, I hope you see that multi-cloud is the new normal. It gives you the flexibility to choose applications and provision it where it makes sense for the business and be able to utilize cloud native tools to increase your productivity. All right, thank you for joining me today.